Hi everyone, this is Aarti and welcome back to my channel. Today, for the first time ever on this channel, we are going to make melt and pour soap. And trust me, it is not easy. I used to think melt and pour soap is just melt and pour, but no, it is not. Today's soap is inspired by a friend of mine called Monika Sootha. She has a YouTube channel called Bath Sutra. Please go and have a look in the description box below. So she had inspired me to make a rainbow soap. So we'll be doing just that. I have cut my soap base. This is a opaque soap base. And we'll be using a smaller mold because I am short on supplies since the lockdown. So let's make some small soap and enjoy the beauty of soap making. Now I am tilting my mold since I want to do a tilted rainbow, and that's why I have put that cloth beneath. I am melting my soap base, adding my required amount of fragrance to it because the first layer is white. So a quick tip, do not use spoon to measure out like this what I am doing it. Use a pipette. I have changed to pipette in my consecutive layers. And tip number two is, whenever you want to add a fragrance to your liquid base, make sure it is not too hot, because if it is too hot, your fragrance, since it's a volatile compound, it will not stay in the base. The right consistency to add a fragrance is, it should be melted, the base should be melted, but it should not be hot. So my second layer is red. I'm going to add some rubbing alcohol to this red mica of mine. I have bought all my micas from Micas and More. I got it delivered to India. I have mixed that with a little bit of rubbing alcohol so that you disperse all your micas properly. Do not ever add mica directly to the base because it will not disperse, it will form clogs. So better you disperse it with either water or rubbing alcohol, whatever micas suit you, or liquid colorant suit you, and then you add it to the base. Again, same tip here, make sure it is melted but not too hot. You do not want to boil your liquid or anything like that. The third tip to make a rainbow soap is, make sure the lower layer which you have already poured in is cooled down nicely. You don't have to completely cool down, but just a little bit. So my fourth tip to do this rainbow soap is, use a spoon, a smaller spoon, so that you break down the fall. I like to use a little bit of depth in my spoon just so that it is easy pour, very nicely, very smoothly. Spatula does not allow me to do that. That's why I am using a spoon. It really makes a big difference. A small equipment can do many things. If you want, you can use that spoon to little by little pour in the batter too. But for my temperatures, this breaking the fall with a spoon was enough. And see, my container is already very clean. So my third layer, again I am using alcohol with mica, allowing my top layer to cool. I am using my fingers to make sure that the top layer is nicely hardened enough, and then I will be mixing my color to the base. Again, the same process, you mix the base very nicely. Make sure you do not boil the base. Sometimes some people really boil the base and there is a weird smell which comes from that base. And the last thing you want is your burnt smell instead of your fragrance in the base or in the soap. So please do not do that. You can use 30 second bursts in your microwave, or if you are using a double boiler method, you melt the base and keep it in a hot water so that it is melted all the time, but it does should not raise the temperature. So you switch off the gas or switch off the induction and let the water be warm and keep the base in it, which is perfectly fine. So now here I am using pipette for the same. I am going to repeat the same process with my spoon. The help of spoon, slowly let it spread around. Make sure everything is equally distributed in all the nooks and corners of this soap. At the same time, you have to be ultra careful that this soap does not splash on the sides, otherwise it will look really weird that the side is covered with 2-3 colors. You want those perfect colors even on the edges. So make sure you do not spill. Even if you spill, there's another quick tip. Just use a popsicle stick to remove the splashes. You can also use your cloth or something like that to wipe that off. Now I'm getting ready for my fourth layer. Again, I am using rubbing alcohol to disperse my mica. properly. Usually what I like to do is once my base is melted, then I will disperse it into alcohol, because if the layer takes time to set and then my base is not yet melted, the alcohol tends to evaporate, and you don't want that. You don't want the last thing to happen is they have blobs of mica in your soap. So just before that, again I'm using my fingers to make sure that the top layer is nice and hard so that I can add in this soap, melted soap to it, using my spoon again to disperse it. Now what I have done is I have used two of my containers to mix this. What you can do is you can reuse the same one, but usually the difference of the colors is too much in the first few layers, and eventually when you go towards the bluer side, you can reuse the same container. Now I'm getting ready for my fifth layer. In fact, my fifth layer is also ready. Again, I'll be pouring the same way. Go slow and steady as you rise above, because it is really important. If you go wrong at this stage, you can't go back and then you'll have to start over again. I have done that in the past, and seriously, it is too frustrating. So you don't want that. Go slow and steady. If there is enough time for you, make sure on the days when you are free and you have 2-3 hours of time, you try and make this soap, because it takes a really long time to do this. What I have done is mixed alcohol. If there is a little bit mica left in the container, I'll again add some alcohol to it and add it to my base. Now I have I have not spoken about the fragrance what I have used. For this soap, I have mixed two fragrance oils together. I have used peach as my main fragrance, and to give a little bit of tinge of citrus, I have used orange fragrance oil. I have used both the oils from Kelkar. They are amazing. As in for melt and pour, they are amazing. But I am really upset when I use the same fragrances for CP soap. It is not that great. Okay, when I mix melt and pour soaps, usually I have a problem with frothing. Sometimes when you mix too hard, or it's just normal, it's soap, so it will froth. So that time you use rubbing alcohol to remove those extra bubbles from the soap, and then try and pour it. If you pour just directly, it tends to have those bubbles right inside, and you really don't want that. So just use a rubbing alcohol spray, so that you get rid of those extra bubbles in the container. And once you have already poured all the soap amount, then you can spray rubbing alcohol from the top. What happens is, if you don't do that, these soap bubbles tend to get inside the soap, and since it's a layer soap, you can't tap it down, right? So in that case, it's better to avoid bubbles as much as possible right in the beginning while making it. Otherwise, you will cut the soap and you will get those huge big bubbles, and it's really very frustrating. So next time I'm doing my last layer. Thank God it took me almost 2 hours. Not even to, I think 3.5 hours to get to this level. So you have to really wait between the layers. And if you are using a slow setting base like mine, it's an amazing base to, if you want to have swirls in your soap. But if you want to do layers, it takes hell lot of time. So I would suggest, if you want to go for soap like this, you can use a fast setting base. But since I had a lot of it, I am just using it and I am waiting. Now I'll be again spraying this with rubbing alcohol to get rid of all those bubbles, and wait for my last layer, which is my ninth layer. And I'm so happy that I have reached here. It is really an achievement for me. So let's do the last layer, and I'm super happy. I am almost done over here. Now you let it just sit there and solidify. I have kept it in the mold for 2 hours, and now I'm going to remove it. Though this is my second time when I'm doing my voiceover, I'm going to see this, and I'm again very, very happy. I can see that from the outside of the mold only. It's so nice and pretty. See, can you see those layers? It's so beautiful. Now let me show you what happens if you don't clean the sides. You can see those yellow marks? I just missed that. Now I'm going to use my scale to mark this. This is a 4-inch loaf, so I'm going to cut it into 1-inch bars for my cutting. And this is a cutter which I sell. If you wish to buy this cutter which cuts even your MNP soap, you can go ahead. Get in touch with me. All the details are in the description box below, how you could get in touch with me, and it will be amazing. A quick tip here is keep the soap in the mold for 2 hours, not more, so it's easier for you to cut. Otherwise it will just take a little bit of more manpower to cut this soap, and it has come out really amazing. I just love how this has come out. Now I'm using my potato peeler to bevel the sides. I have used a beveler before, but I am not pretty happy with it. Potato peeler works better for me, but it's each is to his own. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and let me know what do you think about this soap. I am super excited for this collab, and it was just too amazing. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye.